Welcome to this video of Daily Current Affairs. Today is the 15th of March 2019 and this is our episode 236. If you have not subscribed to our channel Spinnacle and Frontier IAS, then please do subscribe. Click on the subscribe button, hit the bell icon to subscribe the channel. This video is uploaded every day in the English medium on our websites sscclpinnacle.com and belgidhaka.com. Now let me begin with the previous quiz, and these were the questions of the previous quiz. Which country has become the largest importer of weapons? Answer is Saudi Arabia. And Liu Hong is a well-known athlete. So these were the two answers. First question, which Indian defense lab has developed combat drugs to reduce casualties in Pulwama type of attacks? This is the first question, and answer here is going to be INMAS. This is my answer. My answer here is going to be B. B is the right answer. The Institute of Nuclear Medicine and Allied Science, a laboratory of the Defense Research and Development Organization, DRDO, they have come up with a range of cost effective combat casualty drugs that can extend the time till the soldier is shifted to a hospital after an attack. This range of drugs, it can bring down the death toll, and the spectrum includes bleeding wound, super absorptive dressings, and glycerinated salines. These medicines ensure that the soldier does not suffer from unwanted blood loss while being taken to better healthcare from war zones. Now let me give you some information about the DRDO. You all must have heard about the DRDO. It was formed in the year 1958. Its headquarters are located in New Delhi, and it works under the Ministry of Defense. It is charged with military's research and development. So that was the information related to the first question. Let me show you a picture related to this. Okay, here you can see the picture related to this. Here is our picture. Okay, DRDO lab, it develops drugs to reduce casualties in warfare. Next question, here we are on question number two. In question number two, here you have been asked, which of the following is a new species of frog which has been found in the Western Ghats? This is question number two, and the answer here is going to be the starry dwarf frog. Question number two, my answer here is A. Starry dwarf frog, it is a thumbnail sized species. It was recently discovered in India's Western Ghats, one of the world's hottest biodiversity hotspots, and scientists have named the frog Astrobatrachus, okay, for its constellation like markings and the indigenous people, the hill people from where it has been found. So that's the information. Question number two, starry dwarf frog. Next question, which campaign has entered the Guinness World Record for the largest collection of clothes for donation? So recently I've been covering a lot of questions with you on Guinness World Records being created. Here is the question. So what is going to be the answer here? The answer over here is going to be Vastradan. So what is my answer? My answer is Vastradan. Answer here is going to be B. B is the right answer. An official of Guinness Book of World Records, UK, presented a certificate to Lakshyaraj Singh Mewar for the largest collection of clothes for donation after he donated more than 3 lakh clothing items in Udaipur. Okay, this is question number 3. Lakshyaraj Singh Mewar, who is a descendant of Rajpur ruler Maharana Pratap, he started the Vastradan campaign under which 3,29,250 clothes from around 76,000 donors were collected and distributed among the needy people. Now let me show you a picture related to this. See here, you can see the picture. And now let me show you where lies Rajasthan in India. This is the state of Rajasthan. I have often given you this information about Rajasthan. Today I shall talk about the national parks there. The Mukundra Hills, Darha National Park, Desert National Park, Kevladev National Park, okay, Kevladev Ghana National Park, then Ranthambore National Park and Sariska National Park. These are all located in Rajasthan. Let's move on to the next question. Now we are on question number 4. In question number 4, if you take a look, what have you been asked? India has decided not to use which plane after the Ethiopian Airlines crash? Okay, quite a Quite an unfortunate event recently took place. Quite a horrible accident. Question number 4. My answer here is going to be Boeing 737. Boeing 737 is going to be my answer. The Directorate General of Civil Aviation, DGCA, they have decided to ground Boeing 737 MAX 8 aircraft with immediate effect. And the decision comes in the wake of Ethiopian Airlines crash in Addis Ababa, which killed 157 people on board. The plane will be grounded until appropriate modification and safety measures are undertaken to ensure the safe operation. So many other countries, okay, have temporarily grounded the aircraft. It includes China, Australia, Malaysia, Singapore, etc. So question number 4, that is my answer. Let me show you a picture related to this. Here is my picture. Next question, which country is hosting 2019 SAF Women's Championship? This is question number 5. So for question number 5 here, what is going to be my answer? For question number 5 here, my answer is going to be Nepal. Nepal is hosting. So answer question number 5 here is going to be Nepal. The 5th edition of SAF Games Championship 2019, it has started in Biratnagar, Nepal, and when did it start? It has just started on the 12th of March. Okay, the opening match was played between Nepal and Bhutan, and the tournament will be last opportunity for Indian coach Maimul Rocky to fine-tune her team for the crucial 2020 Olympic qualifiers round 2, which is scheduled to be held in Myanmar from April 1st to April 9th. Okay, so that is the information about this question, and now let me show you where exactly is Nepal. Well, Nepal is a neighboring country of India. Here, if you take a look, this is the country of Nepal. What is the capital? The capital here is Kathmandu. Official language is Nepali. Currency is Nepalese rupee. The government is Federal Parliamentary Republic. Vice President is Nand Kishore Pun, and Prime Minister is KP Sharma Oli, and they have a female president there. Next question. Here you can see the picture. Men's soccer, okay, SAF championship, okay. So where is it being held? It's being held in Nepal. Next question, HGS and NASCOM. Okay, HGS and NASCOM will launch Center for Excellence for Differently Abled Persons in which city? This is question number 6, okay? And what is going to be the answer for question number 6? Okay, question number 6 is in front of you. The answer here is going to be Bangalore. Bangalore is going to be my right answer. So, answer is going to be B. Bangalore is the right answer. Hinduja Global Solutions, that is HGS, partnered with NASCOM Foundation to launch a center of excellence in Bangalore for training differently abled persons, which will train a minimum of 100 such persons and make them industry ready over the next 12 months, with a goal to place at least 50% of them in companies already sensitized for hiring them. So that is the information about this question. Okay, question number 6. Here you can take a look at this picture. Next question, according to latest report by the World Gold Council, which country has the world's largest gold reserves? This is question number 7, and the answer here is going to be United States of America. United States of America has the largest reserves of gold in the world. According to the latest report by the World Gold Council India, the world's largest consumer of gold has the 11th largest gold reserve, with the current holding secured at 607 tons. Now, the number one slot is occupied by USA, which has gold reserves of 8,133 tons, followed by Germany. Okay, let me show you a picture related to this. Here you can see the picture related to this. Okay, and then I shall show you where exactly is United States of America. So number one position is for United States, second is Germany, and on third position is Italy. Here, see, you can take a look. This is the United States of America. It lies here. This is India. If you take a look towards the west, you will find the United States of America, and this too is the United States of America. one of the largest countries in the world, located in North America. There are just three countries in North America, as you can see. One is Canada, one is United States of America, and this is Mexico. So this country is the United States of America. Capital, what is the capital here? Washington DC. Largest city is New York City. Government is Federal Republic. President is Donald Trump. Vice President is Mike Pence, and currency here is United States dollar. Let's move on to the next question. We are on next question now, that is question number 8. Who became the first Thari Hindu woman to be elected to the Senate of Pakistan? This is question number 8. And the answer for question number 8 here is going to be Krishna Kumari Kohli. Answer here is going to be Krishna Kumari Kohli. She is the first Thari Hindu woman. The first Thari Hindu woman to be elected to the Pakistan Senate. She has become the first Thari Hindu woman to be selected to the Senate of Pakistan. And she has earlier worked as a crusader for the rights of bonded laborers in Pakistan. She is natively from the village Dhana Gam, located in Sindh. Let me show you her picture. See, this is her picture. Let's move on to the next question. Ved Rahi will be awarded with Kusum Raj. Okay, he is going to be awarded with Kusum Raj Rashtriya Sahitya Puruskar. And he writes in which language? This is question number 9 in front of us. He writes in which language? He writes in the Dogri language. Answer here is going to be Dogri. Dogri is the right answer. Okay, he is a very famous novelist. He is a film director, Ved Rahi. He will be awarded with the prestigious Kusuma Raj Rashtriya Sahitya Puruskar. He'll be given a cash prize of 1 lakh and a memento. Okay. Now, he was born in Jammu in the year 1933 and he has written 7 novels in the Dogri language. Okay. He has also received the Sahitya Academy Award in the year 1983. Let me show you his picture. Well, this is his picture. Next question. Which country is organizing a 34th edition of Ahar 2019, the International Food and Hospitality Fair? That is the question, and answer for this is going to be India. India is organizing this. This is going to be a 5-day long event, okay? 34th edition of AHAR, the International Food and Hospitality Fair, it's going to be organized in India. Answer here is going to be B, okay? The fair, which is organized by India Trade Promotion Organization, is going to begin in New Delhi. China, Germany, Hong Kong, Italy, Indonesia, all of them are going to participate. Here is the picture related to this. Okay. 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. As I told you, these are the dates. Hall number 7, Pragati Maidan in New Delhi. We are over with the 10 questions. Let me take you to the keywords. Combat drugs. Who has started them? In mass has started them. In Western Ghats, a new species of frog, starry dwarf frog, has been found. A new Guinness World Record has been created by Vastradan. Ethiopian Airlines crash. Post Ethiopian Airlines crash, many countries have grounded Boeing 737. India is one of them. 2019 SAF Women's Championship is being held in Nepal. And HGS and NASCOM have had a tie-up to train differently abled people. Then we have here the World Gold Council. They have declared that US has the maximum reserves of gold. Then first Thari Hindu woman to become a member of the Senate is Krishna Kumar Kohli in Pakistan. Ved Rahi, he writes in the Dogri language, is going to be given an award. Okay. Then we have here AHAR 2019 is being organized in India. So these were the summary keywords, and now let me take you to quiz for the day. The first question is, according to latest report by World Gold Council, which country has the world's largest gold reserves? Which country is hosting the 2019 SAF Women's Championship? I want you to answer both these questions and write the answers in the comment section. If you have liked the video, give it a thumbs up, and yes, do not forget to share the video, which is extremely important. I wish you all the best. Thank you for watching. Bye bye.